about to move into the Avoda service,
right?
I feel a supine idea of letting go. No one knows about letting go like Alan was. So I want to read to you what he did, you guys. Do you remember I read this to you last year? Really? So two of you remember. Yeah, Myra, you remember. Definitely, right? Okay, good. So I'll read it again next year. So he says that, I quote, "You have a loving relationship to the world. You don't have to make up your mind what the world should do." I want to repeat that. You have a loving relationship with the world around you. You don't have to make up your mind about what the world should do. That's how your bodies work. You don't have to make up your mind what your nerve cells are going to do. You've delegated all of that. You establish a trust with all of your subordinate organs to carry out their functions without you having to tell each organ what to do. It's not up to you to ensure their success entirely. This is what Alan Watts calls organic power. To trust God, to trust life, to trust your bodies, to trust the process, to let life happen. I spent the better part of 2 years at Kripalu Ashram. That's why my voice is like this. And we learned there just one thing, every day the same thing, over and over again. How we ate, how we slept, how we meditated, how we did our sadhana, how we thought. The philosophy was that the greatest spiritual discipline is moving from making life happen to allowing life to happen. Because Lord knows we want to control. It's the easiest thing to do. Or is it? So we perform an exercise every year, and let's do it again. So if you hold your hand out, you know, with power to the people, and clench your fist, you know, with all the control that you want to have, grasp the maypole and hold on tightly. How long do you think you can hold this? How long do you think we can sit here? But this, this is when you open your hand, the psalmist writes, you feed everything. Everything around you is fed. Not by grasping, not by controlling, not by forcing, not by making.